you. So in this session, we will see the displacement, velocity and acceleration diagrams for the cam and follower mechanism when the follower follows simple harmonic motion. So you might have heard about a simple harmonic motion, right? So simple harmonic motion follows sinusoidal motion, right? Simple harmonic motion follows sinusoidal motion because simple harmonic motion can be represented x is equal to a into sin omega t. So the sine function in the simple harmonic motion equation represents the displacement is sinusoidal form. The displacement curve is of a sinusoidal form, right? So look at this. This is a sinusoidal curve. Like this, the motion of the follower is sinusoidal. That means it is said to be a simple harmonic motion, right? So the amplitude, the displacement value depends on the time of travel of this sinusoidal curve. So displacement x is equal to amplitude a into sin omega t. Sin omega t or sometimes sin omega t plus phi, where t is the variable here. As the t changes, the displacement also changes. That's what we can get it from the simple harmonic motion. Now, according to this motion, the simple harmonic motion follows sinusoidal curve, and this sinusoidal curve is represented like this. Okay, so this x-axis as usual represents the angle of displacement of cam, y-axis represents the displacement of follower. Now this is the displacement curve. Okay, so now here, will you get a constant slope here? You will not get constant slope, right? The slope is varying. Obviously, slope is varying is nothing but there is a change in the velocity, right? Variable velocity, right? So here, this sinusoidal wave gives this type of velocity curve here. This is also a sinusoidal curve. You can take equation x is equal to a into sin omega t, right? That is the displacement. How do you get the velocity equation? Dx by dt, differentiate displacement with respect to time, so that you will get a into omega n into cos omega t. A into omega n into cos omega t. So cos function can be represented in terms of sine function. Sine of 90 plus omega n. Sine of 90 plus omega n into t, you can write cos function. So that means the velocity is also a sinusoidal curve, but with a phase lag of or phase difference of 90 degrees, right? So now you will get a displacement diagram like this, right? And this is the velocity diagram. And when it comes to the acceleration diagram, acceleration, a is equal to rate of change of displacement, rate of change of velocity. So velocity is applying from rate of change of displacement. That means differentiate displacement equation with respect to time, you will get velocity. Differentiate velocity equation with respect to time, you will get acceleration. Then acceleration a is equal to minus omega n square t into sine omega t. So that means the acceleration maintains 180 degrees phase log to the displacement, and velocity maintains 90 degrees phase difference with respect to displacement. And here acceleration is minus omega n square into t. So that means here it follows a cosine function. You will get maximum acceleration and minimum acceleration. So that means minimum acceleration in the sense it is nothing but retardation. Okay. So that's how the displacement, velocity and acceleration diagrams can be represented for simple harmonic motion. We'll solve problems on this displacement, velocity, acceleration diagram. So there you will get clarity over this construction of this diagrams, right? So timing, you just have a look on this diagrams, how this will be and how these are generated. And what is the relation between displacement, velocity and acceleration? That's what you need to understand here, right? Then uniform acceleration and retardation motion. Uniform acceleration and retardatory motion. Right, so next, a third type of motion, follower motion, is uniform acceleration and retardation, retardatory motion, right? So that means in the first case, the velocity is constant. In the third case, the acceleration is constant. That means in the acceleration diagram, you will get a horizontal line. In the acceleration diagram, you will get horizontal line. So look at this, acceleration is constant, that's why acceleration diagram you are getting a horizontal line, line parallel to the x-axis, which indicates zero slope, right? Slope of this curve is zero here, right? So the horizontal line in the acceleration diagram indicates inclined line in the velocity diagram, inclined line in the velocity diagram. That means the acceleration is constant between these two points. When the acceleration is constant there in magnitude, the velocity, how do you get the velocity? Integral of this acceleration, or derivative of velocity gives the acceleration. Is it right? So that means final velocity minus initial velocity. Let us take final velocity is some v meters per second. Initial velocity is zero here. V minus 0 divided by time, you will get acceleration, right? That acceleration is constant here up to this point. Now once again, the velocity is decreasing here, so the velocity is in the increasing, right? The velocity is slowly increasing from 0 to maximum value, from maximum to minimum value. So when the velocity is increasing, you will get acceleration. Or when the speed decreasing, the vehicle is said to be under retardatory motion, right? When you go on increasing the velocity, the vehicle moves with higher speeds. So that means the vehicle is said to have a accelerated motion. So that means here in this region, the follower is in acceleration state, and in this region, the follower is in the retardatory motion. Okay, so if you look at the displacement diagram of the combination of acceleration and retardatory motion here, so up to here, this point, point 4 or H, the follower moves with increasing speed, right? So, and slowly the follower moves with decreasing speed. So that means here, if you look at the curvatures of these two curves, right? Here the curvature is more and here the curvature is less. Curvature is less. Okay. So that's how you can draw the velocity, acceleration and the displacement diagram for a cam and follower mechanism where the follower follows uniform acceleration and retardatory motion. Right, once again, when it reaches to topmost position, there is a dwell period where the follower is at rest. Once again, the displacement is gradually decreasing, that's why it is a return motion. Right, this is a rise motion, dwell motion, and then return motion. This rise return motions may follow acceleration and displacement are varying with respect to time. That's what you need to remember here. Okay, so the acceleration is directly proportional to time here. That's why you will get, the velocity is directly proportional to time here. That's why you will get an inclined line. Okay, so you will get 0 degree curve here, right? And here the velocity acceleration is maintaining the straight line relationship here in the, velocity is maintaining straight line relationship. Okay, then next one. So this is similar to your previous one. Then next one, where the follower follows cycloidal motion, right? You know what do you mean by cycloid? Cycloid is a locus of a point on the circumference of a circle when it rolls on another surface. Cycloid is, what do you mean by cycloid? Cycloid is the curve generated by a point on the circumference of a circle when it rolls on another surface, you take a disc or you take a ball or you take a circular body, you roll it on a flat surface. You select any point on the circumference of this circular body, and if you draw the path of that point at different instants of time when it rolls, then the path is called a cycloidal path. That is simple cycloid. This we have already practiced in our engineering drawings. Okay. So similarly, we have epicycloid and hypocycloid also. When you draw the locus of a point on the circumference of a circle, when it rolls outside the circumference of another circle, you will get epicycloid. When it rolls inside the circumference of another circle, you will get hypocycloid. Right? Now here, these two circles, the rolling circle and directing circle, rolling circle and directing circle. Okay, so the rolling circle is the circle on which the locus point is selected, and here the follower also follows this cycloidal motion, right? When it follows cycloidal motion, the displacement will be of a cycloidal shape, right? You know the procedure to draw the cycloidal shape, right? So that means here the slope is almost zero up to here, and suddenly the slope increases once again. The curve is a constant slope curve. That means here you will get the maximum slope, right? This is maximum slope, and here the slope is zero, and here also slope is zero. Zero slope indicates constant velocity or less velocity, right? Slope is set to zero means slope of displacement diagram is nothing but velocity. If the slope is set to be zero, velocity is set to be zero. But here there is a slight increase in the displacement here, and that indicates smaller velocities, and you will get maximum velocity when the slope is maximum. Where do you get maximum slope? In this portion, you will get maximum slope, right? So the vertical line will have maximum slope, is it right? Horizontal line will have zero slope. Vertical line slope is infinity, because the x coordinate is zero. Y by x is the slope. X coordinate is zero. If x coordinate is zero, slope is maximum, right? So when the curve becomes vertical, or when the graph becomes vertical, the slope is said to be maximum. So in this region of a displacement diagram, the slope is maximum, right? That slope is maximum. Slope maximum indicates the velocity is maximum. Velocity is maximum. Slowly, the velocity reaches to zero here. It is just like a bell curve. It is just like a bell curve, right? The mean is maximum here, and here it almost zero. Okay, then based on this, you can find the velocity, acceleration value. Okay, the slope of this velocity diagram once again gives the acceleration, right? What is the slope of this velocity diagram at this peak most point on the bell curve? It is, what is the slope here? Here the slope is zero, almost the curve is horizontal, right? Slope is said to be zero means acceleration is said to be zero. That's why the acceleration is zero here, and here also the slope is zero, the acceleration is zero. But like your displacement diagram, this velocity diagram also, the slope is maximum in this portion. That's why you will get maximum acceleration here, right? And since the velocity is progressing, or velocity is increasing, that's why you will get acceleratory motion. And here the velocity is decreasing from maximum value to minimum value, and this is decelerator motion or retardatory motion. That's why in this region the follower subjected to retardation, and in this region the follower is subjected to acceleration. Okay, so that's how the displacement, velocity and acceleration diagrams are represented for cam and follower mechanisms, when the follower follows different motions like uniform velocity motion, right? And later, simple harmonic motion, and then uniform acceleration and deceleration motion, and then cycloidal motion.